Hello, welcome to the kitchen. Today, I'm gonna teach you how to do a sunflower sprouts guacamole. This recipe is designed for kids and also for parents to help kids with their eating. As you know, kids sometimes they don't like vegetables, but they like avocado. So this recipe is really easy to do, but at the same time, very nutritive. So as you can see, I have some ingredients here and I'm gonna teach you very quickly how to do this in less than 5 minutes. So the first ingredient, of course, for a guacamole, it's avocado. You're gonna need 2 avocados for this recipe and they need to be quite ripe. Otherwise, it's gonna be hard to blend it. So you're gonna cut this avocado in halves, check if they're good, and then you're gonna cut the other one. Avocados, guys, it's very, very rich in monounsaturated fatty acids, oleic acid, and it's very nutritive for you. What I like about avocado, it contains vitamin C, vitamin E, vitamin K. It is rich in vitamin B as well, and has calcium, potassium, magnesium. It's really good for females and males, and it's good for people that have high cholesterol. So avocado is excellent for spread on your toast. It's good for dips, especially if you are doing a weight loss or you want to stay healthy. So here we go. What do? You scoop the avocado, put it in a blender. That's the first ingredient. And then all you need to do now is just take as much as you can from the skin of the avocado. Avocado came from South America or Central America, and is from the same family as cinnamon and camphor and bay leaves. Did you know that? And some people call alligator pear. So it's very interesting because it does look like a little bit of a reptile skin, alligator. So in South America, that's how they call. Here you go. That's all you do. And now you scoop the last one. This recipe should cater for about 4 adults. And it's very good for parties because it's a healthy dip. Next ingredient, it's sunflower sprouts. What I like about sunflower sprouts, it's very nutritive. It has a lot of protein, very little amount of fats, very little amount of carbohydrates, but it's very good for digestion. It has enzymes and it's very delicate on the taste, so it won't affect the guacamole. If you add some other sprouts, for example, radish or broccoli, it might affect the taste, but it's totally up to you. You can use any other sprouts that you want. You can use you can actually use rockets instead of sprouts. And with rockets, it's quite peppery, but very refreshing. It's really good for some wraps and sandwiches. So here we go. You add 1 handful of sunflower sprouts. You normally find sunflower sprouts on the markets and also health food stores. Next ingredient, guys, you're gonna need onions. If you don't like onions, you can use garlic instead. 1 garlic clove for 1/4 of an onion. Onions, it's good because it contains a lot of sulfur. It's really good for the liver. It also has properties that are antiviral, antibacterial, really support this immune system of adults and kids and elderly. So I always recommend garlic and onions for everyone. As you know, I'm a big one on, you know, spices and aromatic flavors. And I love onions for this recipe because add a little bit of flavor and also the nutrition, fiber, and a little bit of sugars as well. I love nutritive salt, as you know. This is a Celtic salt. As you can see, it's quite coarse. And this salt, it's unrefined. This is a natural salt, and what I like it, it contains a lot of minerals. In fact, contains about 82 nutrients. You can use Himalayan salt or you can use any other salt, as long as it's natural and unrefined. Because remember, guys, if you use refined salt, you're only getting sodium and chloride, which is not very good for you, because a lot of products nowadays have a lot of sodium. So invest in a good salt, and I guarantee it will add a lot of nutrition to your life. Next ingredient, it's lime. You can use lemon, but I love lime because for this recipe, it adds an extra flavor there, very nice and fresh and tropical. But if you don't have lime available in the market, that's fine, you can use lemon. This definitely is one of the main ingredients for the guacamole. It does make the guacamole last longer in the fridge, because lemon contains a lot of vitamin C. And when you add that to the guacamole, it keeps the guacamole from oxidizing. As you know, if you cut the avocado, it starts to get black. That's oxidation, it's aging because interacting with the oxygen. When you put vitamin C in avocados or any other fruit, for example, apple, you can rub the lime on the apple and it won't go dark because vitamin C stops the oxidation, stops the aging. So that's why we have to consume antioxidants as well to avoid our own natural aging. The last ingredient, it's water. And why I'm adding water is to kickstart the reaction there to help the blending, but more importantly, to make it slightly runny. And once you put that in the fridge, it will become quite nice consistency. What you need to do now is just mash down so it blends quite rapidly. And that's it, guys. Let's go. Now, this recipe, it's ready. As you can see, it's very quick to do. You just need about probably 20 seconds in a blender. A very good blender will do the job very quickly. And now all you need to do is pour that into a container, or if you're gonna serve to your guests on the spot, you can do just before serving because then it's nice. Or you can prepare ahead, leave in the fridge, and when your guests get to your party, you just put at the table. This guacamole sunflower sprouts will last for about 5 days in the fridge. So it's a very good recipe to keep in the fridge for kids to consume after school or after activities or before activities. It's a light snack. And you can serve that with a lot of options like vegetable sticks, or you can use whole grain crackers. So I'm gonna teach you now how to do a healthy option here. So here I got carrots. So if you wanna do a little bit of carrot sticks, which is very nice with this guacamole, gives a nice contrast of color, but more importantly, it's, you know, vegetables. It helps kids to eat vegetables. You just cut that, look at that. And then what you can do, you can cut that in half again, and then cut that in half again. And now you do these sticks. Nice and thin ones will be ideal because then you are actually making it looks attractive to kids to consume it. And do the same thing. Here you go. Be careful with your hands. Cut that in half and then do more sticks. You can do that with cucumber, celery, and wombok, Chinese cabbage. So I'm gonna show you here how you can use Chinese cabbage in this recipe. So you grab one or two leaves. Here you go. Now all you need to do, you cut the laterals, and you can set that aside for later if you want. And you're gonna use just the middle. You can use that for salads. Don't discard that, that's pretty good. And now what you need to do is cut that in sticks, like that. So it's a nice contrast of colors. Here you go, and you set that aside. Some people like capsicum for dips. I like it for this recipe. It gives a nice sweet flavor. And also capsicum, it's very rich in vitamins as well, rich in fiber. It adds a nice contrast to your table. It's red. I like to play with colors. And to be honest, guys, the more color you eat, the better for you. So you can do that and leave it there. And then the last ingredient is cucumber. You can use Lebanese cucumber, or you can use continental cucumber, like they call. You're gonna cut the cucumber in half. And then what you need to do is now just cut in thin strips. Here we go. And then you cut in half. Here we go. And then you put that. Look at that. It's starting to get a lot of colors. This is a perfect snack for summer, for autumn, for spring, even for winter, that's fine. This is an entree. This is an afternoon snack for when kids get home. And guys, this is an awesome way to help kids to eat more vegetables on a daily basis. If you want something different, you can then use maybe a little bit of organic corn tortillas, and that goes well with the avocado. So here you go. This is my sunflower guacamole sprout. Very nutritive, very easy to do, cost effective, and lasts 5 days in the fridge. So stay tuned, and I'm gonna teach you more recipes in the next few videos. Thank you.